Hello friend, this lecture is also available in Hindi and Urdu language. If you want to watch in Urdu and Hindi language, you can take the link in the description of this video. Today our topic is difference between 16-bit timer and 32-bit timer. Okay, mostly students raise a question why we need 32-bit timer, and also raise a question what are the main difference between 16 and 32-bit timer. So in this lecture we will discuss about both timers, why we need 32-bit timer and what's the fault in 16-bit timer. So this lecture number is 10. A major difference between 16 and 32-bit timer is timer delay range. Okay, major and main difference between two timers is time delay range. Okay, a 16-bit is O1 time range and 32-bit is O1 time range. So we will discuss both time range, what's the main difference between 16 and 32-bit time range. Okay, for our first is 16-bit timer. By name you understand it, this timer has 16 bit. Okay, so I write 16 bit and every bit is 1 because I want to take maximum value. If I put 1 in 16 bit timer, so it will give maximum value. So I change maximum binary value, this is our maximum binary value, and change to decimal value, then we get 32,767. This is the maximum value of this timer. So this timer has maximum range is 32,767. This is the range. Okay, Lord, let's take an example. As I told you in my lecture number 9, every timer has its own base. Some timer has 1 millisecond base time and some has 10 milliseconds. So we take a example 100 millisecond. This is the maximum timer in our Delta PLC. So I take this example. If we use 100 millisecond base timer, then maximum delay will be produced by 16-bit timer is this value. This value come multiply by 100 millisecond is our base time, and this our maximum value. So when I convert this millisecond to minutes, then I will get 54.61 minutes. Okay, so the maximum delay by this 16-bit timer is 54.61 minutes. Okay, furthermore, if you want to produce more delay than 54.61 minute, then you have to use 32-bit timer. These are all answer of this lecture. If we want to take more delay than this value, then we have to use 32-bit timer. Okay, so main difference is time delay, and time delay of this timer of 16-bit is 54.6 minutes. So due to this reason, we need a timer which can produce more delay. So we have this one. Come on, 32-bit timer, same by name it has 32 bits, and I write there, and I write 1 because 1 has a maximum value. If I write 32 bit by 1, so it will give maximum value. So when I change maximum value to decimal value, so I will get this value. Okay, this is the maximum value by 32-bit timer. So it's approximately 2,147,000,000, and for 100 83,000. So we will talk just is approximately 2 billion. So a same example as I take in 16 bit, if you use 100 millisecond base timer, then maximum delay will produce by 32 bit this one value, and when I change it by millisecond to minutes, then this value will come. This is the maximum value which will be produced by 32 bit. So it's a very high and more than this value. So this reason we need 32 bit timer. This is the main difference between 16 and 32 bit timer. Now let's come on. So is the answer. Hence, you want to produce delay more than 54.61 minutes, then you have to use 32 bit timer. Now let's come over VPL software. This is our VPL software, as I explained in my lecture where how to install it. Okay, there we over the lecture number 110, and PLC name is yes to okay. Maximum one is input, and now we will talk about timer. I will read timer T0. The timer 0 is 16 bit timer, as I explained in my lecture. This is a 16 bit timer. We will talk of the ranges. T0 is a 100 millisecond timer. It's a basic 100, it's a maximum, because other one has 10 millisecond and 1 millisecond. It's a maximum. I take this. So as I told you, the range will be 32,767. The K value, this is the K value. The maximum value is this one, 32,000, and minimum value is 0. So here, if I put 32, then timer will accept this value. But I change 7/8, then it will be an input error, because this value is increased. Because as I told you in my lecture, the maximum value is 32,767. So I put 8 simple, then give the input error. So we can put below this value, like I put 0, then it will set. So this is the main difference in our 16 bit timer and 32 bit timer. So but in our data PLC, it has no 32 bit timer, it has a 16 bit timer. So in other PLC like Allen Bradley and CMA, it has a oven 32 bit timer. So our lecture is completed. So if you have any question, you can raise a question over by comment box, and also send email. So our team will give to answer. Okay, bye.